518 in progress. I-34 in progress. I-18 complete. I-15 in progress. I-34 complete. I-15 complete. I-36 in progress. I-51 in progress.
have a visual.
Roger.
We have visual.
Roger.
Roger.
Roger. on the ground.
Thank you again for your time, Mr. Kogan. And thanks for your patience. Next Thursday, we'll have another meeting, by which time I will have some new questions for you. If you remember something new before our next meeting, not just about Jack Boyd, but about your work in the police department as a whole, then just let me know. If you change your work schedule, let me know. If you need to leave Freeburg for some reason, well, you understand. Let me know.
Don't look at me, Mr. Kogan. I don't want to be here any more than you do. If it was up to me, neither one of us
Thank
would
you again,
to.
Mr. Kogan. You are free to go.
Take it easy on these people, Lana. They don't have to.
I'm just doing my job, Wilton. It's your job too, remember? Please invite Miss Emma Weinstein in.
Emma Weinstein? Again? What is this already, her sixth?
Just the fourth.
And you're hoping to learn something new. As far as I recall, she just keeps saying the same thing.
I will definitely learn something new, Wilton. Even if she keeps saying the same thing. Even the fact that she always repeats all the answers word for word. That's already very important information just by itself.
Well, yes, 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 for you. Because the whole world around you is very important information.
Good morning, Miss Weinstein. I'll ask you some questions, some of them new, others I've already asked you during previous interviews. But I hope that you'll be kind enough to...
You can ask me any questions, Miss Berman. I'll answer you. For the second time, the fifth, the tenth, as long as it takes. You know that.
Then let's not waste any time.
534 in progress. Code I. 530 in progress. Complete. Complete. Five 540 in progress. Five 540 complete. Five 530 in progress. Six in progress. Five 5:30 complete. F-16 in progress. F-16 complete. Thank you.
ground.
Roger.
Roger.
Five eighty.
595. Roger.
Do you see him, Pedro? Has he already ordered a drink? What? What, Chihuahua? Are you sure you're looking at the right guy? Do you see a basket of strawberries? Pedro, not everything is important. It doesn't matter how he's dressed. A basket of strawberries. Do you see it? Has he already started eating the strawberries? All right, Pedro. Don't worry about that. If he's eating strawberries from a basket, then he's the one we need. No doubt. Just wait until he's eaten all the strawberries and then approach him, right? Right, Pedro. I'll be waiting for your call. Just stick to the plan, all right? Pedro?
It's me.
Jack. Yeah, I was sure you must be dead.
Look, Fry, I know that
I hear there's a federal agent who's interested in you. He's already reached Millington. From there, I think he'll be heading north. What do you think, Jack? Has he picked up your trail?
Fry, let's just talk.
Jack, how happy he'll be to find out you're still alive. A young agent, let's call him Chris, dreaming of a brilliant career. He wants to prove to his alcoholic father that he's made something of his life. And the girl, let's call her Tanya. She's recently left him. So he just loved to play the hero all over the front page and then just rub her nose in it. and Chris? Chris has an arrogant colleague, too. Let's call him Tommy, who's always laughing at him. wait. You know what, Jack? I think Tommy's fucking Tanya. I mean, this whole time. How could I have missed it? Tommy's fucking Tanya. And worse, the alcoholic father is banging Tanya, too. I mean, they're all fucking around over there. And just think about poor old Chris.
Fry, let's just...
and by the way, did I mention that Chris has a bit of a stutter? Naturally, that meant problems at school. And not just at school, but at the academy, too. Yeah, he was nearly kicked out of the academy twice, even though his marks were brilliant. Imagine, they were ready to kick the guy out just because he stutters a little. No, nobody wants to have anything to do with him. You know what that's like, Jack, huh? And suddenly, our stutterer Chris, less than 6 months at the Bureau, he catches a fugitive off the federal wanted list. And not just anyone, but Jack Boyd, the king of corruption. I mean, the symbol of our whole society's disintegration. Al Capone in a police cap. Nobody else could do it. But there's just something about Chris, you know, Jack?
Good Lord, Fry, it's just...
Now, Tanya wants to fuck him, and the prom queen Sharon wants to fuck him, and even Susie the ballerina, who turned him down on 3 separate occasions because she didn't want to have anything to do with the fucking stutterer. Well, now Susie is showing off her pirouettes in his bedroom. And it's all thanks to you, Jack. All thanks to the fact that you couldn't stick to our simple arrangement and answer the fucking phone when I called.
I couldn't pick up the phone because at the moment when you called, the phone was literally being shot at. And then
You're one lucky bastard, Jack. I mean, you are lucky that I have such a cold, black heart, completely incapable of compassion, without batting an eyelid. I will leave that poor stutterer Chris with nothing. I'll make a couple of calls, and he'll turn right around on that road he's on to Sharpwood and return to his miserable life of the lonely loser. He's just not the right man for Tanya. I mean, some people just aren't made for each other, you know? True, you'll have to pay me twice as much.
Twice? 20,000? But I only just...
That's not the worst of it, Jack. You not only have to pay me twice as much, but you'll have to do it 4 times as often. 20,000 a week. I hope whatever mess you got yourself in, you still got all your fingers, or at least enough of them to pull out a bank transfer. How long until the next payment? Huh? 4 days?
Come on. Let's talk,
I'm sorry, Jack. I have another call. I'm guessing that Mr. Cervantes just finished eating his strawberries.
His what? Strawberries? Listen, Fry, I'm just asking you... Fuck.